I'm going to show you inside and how the people who are living in the house went up the roofs with all their families.
Mm-hmm.
Her and her family were able to, you know, break this iron sheet to go up so that they can seek refuge up here. So actually this is a very big hole that I'm being told to be careful. This one, it's a hole, big hole. So I should be moving, stepping on the stones. Yo, what's up guys, how you doing? Koech on the move right here, and I'm back in a place called Kianda in Githurai. You remember last week, just 7 days from today, because today is on a Saturday, we were somewhere here around this area down there. We were here distributing blankets to the people who were affected by the floods in this area of Githurai. We gave out over 400 blankets and each one of them got one packet of unga. And I've come to assess the situation since it's still raining right here in Nairobi. The disaster is still really a mess. It's wreaking havoc still. And people have not come to their houses where they were living. And I decided someone who we gave the blankets asked me to come here so that they can show me around the effects of this flood. So I've come here so that we can check what's going on, how the people are living. Approximately 1 month after the floods wrecked havoc in this area of Githurai. So we are near the river which really caused all this mess. So I'm gonna show you these houses. You can see it was a church or something. There are houses here where people are living. As you can see, these were people's houses, but now people are no longer living here because the waters are a lot, and it's like over 1 month since the floods wreaked havoc here. So I want to show you the river actually which caused all this mess.
So,
oh, there were houses here actually from across this area. There were houses here up to that one, you can see, and this was mabati houses, and the waters carried them away. Now people were living here, right?
You see, that one was the church.
This was the church.
Yeah.
Okay. Now this is the main river. This is the main river yenye ilileta shida. And nasema kwa hii area hii ndio main river. Okay. So as you can see guys, this one here is Thika Super Highway. Actually we are not far from the highway, and these are the houses where people were living, and they were displaced because of the raging floods. And it's almost over 1 month actually since this disaster happened, but you can see it's still really fresh and people have not come to their houses. So we are going to walk around this Kianda area of Githurai so that Githurai Deakin College, so you can see, we are going to walk around so that we can see the impact of this flood. We are also going to talk to the people who are affected. We understand their lives after the flood wreaked havoc in this area. So make sure you're watching this video from the start to end. My name is Koech on the move. Don't forget to subscribe and give it a thumbs up. Mfuate msichana kuonyesha. Imagine this is 1 month after the floods and it's still really very disturbing. Yeah, this was actually a road, but as you can see, it's no longer a road. It's like the waterway. The water is flowing through the houses, these houses. And these ones. Eh? And these ones were flooded. So let's get in here. We see how this flood impact affected the people. As you can see, it doesn't look like this place is habitable as for now. As you can see, a lot of waters, you know, Yeah. So there is a lady I talked to last time. We gave her a blanket, and we are going to talk to her to show us the how this flood affected them, and also we walk around, we see what's still happening 1 month after the floods. Okay. So actually, as you can see, all this plot was really affected by the floods, and people are not here. There are a lot of houses. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, and then this other side, there are a lot of houses, and people are not currently living. Remember, the people who are living here were families. This would maybe a family of 5, 4, but you can imagine where they are living right now. But we are going to ask the people who are here to know where these people went to. So as you can see, I don't have a gumboot, so I'm trying to go the far end. So these houses are closed actually, so we cannot, but we are going actually to get into that house, the last house in this side, so that we can see how it looks inside after the floods. Remember, the floods happened 1 month, over 1 month ago. Those clips where you are seeing the people up the roofs, there were these houses, and I'll show you how that happened, or I'll show you how it happened that they went up the iron sheet roofs when we get in that house. And before that, let's go this way. I'm struggling really where to step, because I don't want my shoes to get to take in water. So look, so these are all the houses which were affected. Oh, look at that, it's really bad. You can imagine 1 month after the floods. 1 month after the floods, this is how it looks like. And that time, people were on the roofs. Yesterday actually it rained. Today is on 25th of May 2024. Yesterday it rained a lot. There were a lot of rain, and that is why you can see there are still water here. And they are telling me before April May floods, this area was like this. They never imagined that it will happen, that they will leave their homes and just seek refuge elsewhere. The river that I'm talking about is like there, it's like 100 meters from where we are right now, but you can see the impact came all the way up to here. So that's it, there are clothes here, people hang their clothes, most of them, you know, they left their pillows, the clothes here, and even the shoes. Wow, it was so devastating. So as I told you, we are going to get into one of the houses where the floods are really affected, just right here. And I'm going to show you inside and how the people who are living in the house went up the roofs with all their families. There is a lady who was living in that house with, I think, 3 children. And they went up the roof themselves. And they are really lucky to be alive. They are shy of the camera, but I'm still trying to talk to them to see if they will appear on the camera. They don't want to appear on the camera. Yeah, so this is the other side of this plot. There are quite a number of houses. These were the toilets that I was using actually. As you can see, bathroom, yeah. And you can see the water is still flowing here. Wow, people left and they left. You can see these houses, they are draining water. You can see even that one. So these houses are inhabitable actually. And let me tell you, these are the things that you cannot see on mainstream media. There is no media house which will come here to show you what I'm showing you right now. For us as Kenya diaspora media, we walk right into the victims' whereabouts. We ask them the question, because those are the ones who have the real story. We don't ask the authorities. Of course, we can engage them, but we mostly go directly to the the affected victims, because they have the real story. If you go to the authorities, they will lie to you, especially they will play with numbers. You see, even these women who I came to talk to, they, after arriving, all of a sudden they started saying that they are not going to appear on the camera since the government told them not to appear, because, but they don't understand that the government don't want the shame. They don't want the shame to be shown to the people. But now they don't really understand that the media, especially digital media, will give them the voice to speak. They will give them the advantage to show the troubles and problems they are facing. That is exactly what we are doing. That is why we risk our lives going to places, you know, we get into water. For example, you can see sewage, you know, not clean water, obviously, to bring exclusive stories, the real stories of what really happened, you know, or what is happening. But they don't understand. I try to talk to them, but I think they fail to understand. So you can see, these are the children's school uniform, and nobody is living here. All these houses are flooded since April, when the floods wreaked havoc in these areas. People went up the roofs, you know, to save themselves, and their houses were submerged with water. So I want to take you to inside the house that I told you, where we got some ladies there who they agreed to show us their houses, but they are refusing to show me their faces. But let's go in and see how they got up and went up the iron sheet roofs to save their young children. I understand that the woman in that house have a child of less than a year, maybe 6 or 4 months baby, and yeah, that's so unfortunate. We are going to see if she can talk to tell us how they really did it, how they were able to survive. So let's do this. So this is the one of the houses which was submerged by water, and you can see from the look, you can see there is a sofa right here, you can see the beddings, you can see even the clothes. It shows that there was a family living here. And up there in the roof, I don't know if you can see, there is some reflection of the sunshine. There is a reason why this iron sheet roof is like that. So that's the bed, and this house is inhabitable up to now as we speak. It's like over 1 month since this happened. Unakumbuka siku yenye hii ili happen, hiyo tarehe? Ilikuwa April? Over 1 month, right? Yeah, so over 1 month, and you can see that the family are not able to come back to live here. So apa hivi hii nini ili happen aje?
Tulibomoa, ilibidi tukabomoa juu. Maji ilikuja, tukaona sasa tutakufia huku. Tukasema sasa wacha tujisaidie vile tutaweza, hata Mungu alisema Mungu ajisaidie. Tukang'oa mabati tukalala huku.
Oh, so mlingoa mabati ndo muende juu?
Eh, tukalala huku juu. Toka saa 9 ya usiku.
Eh.
Tulingoa hivyo. Ah, tunaona ni Mungu tu tukianguka huku.
Eh, ndo
zimefujika.
Naweza kanyaga huku?
Eh, kanyaga.
Anyeshe tu vizuri. So this actually, she's telling me that when they realized that there was waters inside this house, they now, her and her family were able to, you know, break this iron sheet to go up so that they can seek refuge up here on the iron sheet roof. And remember, it was very cold at night. Ilikuwa saa ngapi usiku?
Saa 9 ya usiku.
Wow, uliko na familia watu ngapi hapa?
Nilikuwa na katoika miezi mbili na wasichana watatu.
Oh, ule mtoto ni miezi mbili?
Miezi mbili. Hata hapo amefikisha miezi mbili. Juu alidugua kama tumetoka huku hii mwezi wa tano. 10 weeks.
Oh, na so alikuwa mtoto wa miezi mbili na wengine watatu. Na ukamanage aje kutrek
hapa? Wengine walitoka kwa hizi manyumba zingine wakakuja huku. Tukakaa na wao sasa hivi bila maji ilizidi kwao. Ndiyo tukajadiliana, tukangoa hii mabati, tukakaa huko juu.
Okay. Kuto ilikuwa saa ngapi?
Saa 9.
Saa 9 usiku,
eh?
Ehe.
Tukakaa huko, tukanyeshewa, tukafumilia, jua ikakuja, ikawaka, tukafumilia, hatujui kama tutaokolewa. Then sasa ndivyo huko matamani tukafanyiwa. Tukakuja tukaokolewa na wanajeshi wa huko kahawa.
Oh, hiyo ilikuwa saa ngapi?
Saa 7 ya mchana. Sasa.
Oh, so mlikaa masaa mingi sana. Eh.
Almost 8 hours.
And the iron sheet roofs is very cold.
We, hata sitakage kukubuka hiyo siku. Juu nilistuka hapo na hapo. Hadi maziwa ikapotea mtoto. Karusi kilo zikaanza kuteremka sasa hadi wa leo. Tunaona sasa ndio nimekuja sasa nimekuja kama nitabeba hiyo kitanda. Sina usaidizi yote.
Okay. Na mlikuja tu mkaokolewa hivyo tu?
Tukatolewa tu tukapelekwa huko. Huko juu. Kutolewa huko juu tukaenda tukapelekwa shule iko pale. Sisi tulikuwa tunakaa hapo.
Oh, so mpaka leo mnakaa?
Sasa tunakaa.
Na naona kwa hizi manyumba zote ziko hapa ni hii plot. Ni manyumba mingi sana na hakuna watu wanakaa already.
Hakuna walihama. Wezi kaa hapa. Hiyo maji bila waliona. Hata wewe mwenyewe wezi kaa.
Wezi kaa.
Bado itakuja
kama hiyo. Na hii maji yenye naona hapa nje. Hii maji yenye naona hapa nje. Ilikuwa ni ya ile mvua ilinyesha jana ama ni bado ile floods?
Ile flood na mvua inanyesha. Huku kuna ziwa la nyuzi zenye zinapeleka maji huko Lowai. Sasa hizo zilifungika kutoka hiyo siku. Hizo zinafanya maji inarudi na inakuja inajaa kwa ploti. Hii nyumba sikuwa nimeiacha na maji. Lakini leo si unaona kuna tumaji tuko kwa huko hakukuwa na maji.
So inamaanisha hata after the floods kuisha bado haiko safe.
Haikitoka maji hiyo. Kipaya kabisa ikitoka maji.
So according to you unaweza ona maybe hadi lini ndo inaweza kuwa rudi normal ama haitairudi. Ama shida yenye inaleta hii maji ni nini kutoka hiyo siku? Siwa line. Yenye iko wapi?
Zikifunguka ziko hapa za Moshaina. Zikifunguka hizo ni hiyo maji, hii maji yote hata utaipata hata within 5 minutes itakuwa imeisha. Hiyo sasa hii kama itafunguka itaenda tu pole pole. Alafu hii nini? Iki mvua inyesha tena hata sio mvua tu. Unaona yenye iko tu kwa hizo nini pale huko chini. Bado ndio tu inatoka kwa nini.
Oh, kwa hivyo si hata river tena inaleta hiyo shida. Okay.
Ndio yasi wanaji.
So hapa hivi kulikuwa na ubomozi iliendelea kama for example Mathare na Mukuru South B huko. Hapa kwenu kuna ubomozi yoyote ile happen?
Hakuna. Walikuwa tu wamesema watabomoa nini 30 meters from kwa mto. Lakini hadi saa hii hawajai kuja.
Lakini nyinyi mko more than 30 meters from mto.
More than 30 meters.
Okay. Na bado mko affected TV sasa? Ile usaidizi yoyote yenye mmepata kutoka kwa serikali?
Tumepata. Usaidizi kama ya chakula hivi tu blanketi na mattress.
Hiyo ni serikali.
Mtu kama mimi ningekuwa nalalia wapi? Hebu angalia mafisi yangu.
Hii mattress sasa ililoa maji.
Tunaona imekunywa maji. Ile kitu ilikuwa juu ni hizo hizo blanketi. Sasa
ndio hizo mpaka manguo ndio hizo.
Na kitanda unaona kwenye tu bado hizo. Na hapa kwenye kuna hizo, kuna hiyo mattress, chini kuna vyombo za kupikia sasa vilibeba mchango
hizo. Hadi naona hapa nini kitu ya kupikia.
Na kama hizo ni sahani.
Kuna kikombe hapo sana.
Hii ni pan.
Okay. So kila kitu tuseme zilienda tu.
Tumeanza zero kama kikombe hatuna. Zote tunapewa kwa mti yangu vitu zote. Kwa hizi manyumba ufunguliwe iko tu hivi.
Naona hizi manyumba zote hakuna mtu hapo.
Hakuna mtu.
Okay.
Na unaona vile tuko bali na mtu. Tuko bali sana.
Hiyo upomozi haitawafikia.
Haitatufikia.
Na sasa hapa ni rental, mna rent hapa?
Tuna rent.
Sasa mwenye ploti anything anasema
yes,
nini?
Amehama.
Alikuwa naishi hapa.
Kwake ni pale chini.
Oh, ni huko chini. Kwa hii same place hapa. Anaishi wapi? Huko nini? Huko kwana Oh. So huko ndo kwake. Na pia yeye amehama. Yeye anasema nini? Anangoja usaidizi ya serikali ama? Anangoja serikali nini usaidizi ya serikali ama amewaambia nini?
Sasa atakuja usaidizi ya serikali kuna serikali inasaidiana kweli? Sikizani wasaidiana siku hizo.
Okay. Sawa.
Sio kama ile ilikuwa inalia kitabu.
Hapa ni tofauti.
Hii ni tofauti. Hii hata kama tuliamka mapema kuchaguana.
Okay. So mko tu saa hii wewe unaishi wapi ama watu wenye wanaishi ploti wote? Unaweza sema wako wapi?
Kila mtu aliende na njia zake. Kila mtu njia zake sasa watakuja wakisikia maji. Wanakuja wengine kuangalia kama maji imekaa.
Wengine bado wako kwa mashule, makanisa. What, man? You can imagine my shoes got into water, and I'm told actually this is not water. That place is just sewage. Well, I wish I came with gumboots. This is so serious, man. So guys, you've seen actually here in Kidurai, people are still homeless. They are, most of them are living in maybe schools, churches. Some of them went to the village. Some of them are living with relatives, and this is the situation. Thank you so much for watching that video. See you in the next one.